Okay, so now that you have finished your color practice, we're going to start painting our false to life. And today we're going to work on the background. When we paint our background, we are going to be using the cool colors, but again, you get the primary colors and you will have to mix. So the background on this picture are the areas that are the empty spaces where the pumpkins are not. So I have this space back here to paint. I have this space over here to paint. And I have this small space here. When you paint, I want to see all three cool colors. And the three cool colors are blue, green, and purple or violet, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and start with some blue. I'm just gonna take my brush and dip it into the paint. And when I begin, I'm gonna do this section blue and then I'm gonna try to turn it into some green and I'll show you how we can do that. But I first start on my edges. Notice how the bristles of my brush are the only part that's touching the paper. I set it down and I sort of pull it along. And then I continue on the edge very carefully. Now here, as I start to run out of paint, I flipped my brush over to see if I could get it to go a little bit further. And then once you start to see the paint not showing up on the paper anymore, you don't want to press harder because that's going to hurt your brush. What you want to do is get more paint. So I'm going to go back and dip in. And now that I have my edge done, I can paint a little bit quicker on the inside. Okay. And because I am using the same color, I can go rather quickly. Now, let's say I want to turn this into some green. So what I'm going to do, I have two containers here, so I'm just, because I want it to turn green, I'm not going to mix it in here. I'm actually going to just dip my brush into the yellow, and then I'm going to do the mixing on my paper. And so by taking the yellow and putting it inside the blue, it blends on there. I can go back and get more yellow and stick it where the green is, and that can make it a little bit lighter. What I want to see is these variations. And now I can take the paint on my brush and continue on the edges. Here. See if I can get this little part still. And then I can go back and continue mixing with my paints. So I want you to sort of have fun with this and do a lot of mixing together. Now I want to go back to my blue over here. Start on my edge. And continue my lines carefully. I'm going to go all the way to the edge, okay? Maybe put a little more yellow at the top here. And it's okay if you get a little bit of paint on the table because I want you to go all the way to the edge. We have washcloths and we'll take care of that, okay? So there you can see the transition from blue to green. Let me just try and finish this up here. What I also want to see, though, is a transition from blue to purple. But it's not a good idea to do those two next to each other because when you mix all three colors, all three primary colors together, you get a neutral color or a brown looking color. So I would finish this area here with green and then I'm gonna go down here and do my blue to purple transition. So because I have green on my brush and I don't want that to be mixed with red because those are complementary colors, that'll make a brown. I'm gonna clean up my brush. See how I'm tapping it at the bottom? Then I want to use my fingers to squeeze out the brush and see, oh, there's still some blue in there, so I'm going to keep tapping. Okay, and there you can see that water is pretty much dry, or clear. I want to dry my brush so my paints don't get runny. So, I'm going to do basically the same thing, starting with blue this time, here, outlining my edges, very carefully, taking my time. But this time when I transition from the blue, I'm going to add red instead of the yellow. So I want to work on doing my edges first. A little bit more blue. And I can paint some of the space itself with the blue. And now I'm going to take and add some red to it. When you do this, you want to be careful not to add too much red. So that it doesn't look like a purple. It looks more like a red violet. So you can see how this is turning into the purple. that I was hoping for. And I'm going to do just a little bit more red to fill in this space here. And go all the way off the paper. So there you have seen a transition from
blue to purple.
This one might be a little bit harder to see.